Your daughter is running against an incumbent in Wyoming. They're calling her a carpetbagger. There's a lot of vitriol going back and forth.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, you are personally involved in that. How do you feel?
I'm delighted. Liz is somebody who's, I think, got the experience. I think it's extraordinarily important for our party to bring along that next generation of leaders. And she's 47 years old, a mother of five, an attorney, two tours in the State Department. Had her own committee that was set up after we got into the problems after 9/11. She's a great candidate, and she's working her fanny off. And
How do you react to the carpetbagger thing, though? She's moving in.
I was accused of being a carpetbagger, Larry, after I'd spent 10 years in Washington working for Jerry Ford and so forth. I went back home to Wyoming, and, of course, they said carpetbagger. It wasn't true. She's got ancestors that go back to two great-great-grandmothers who walked the Mormon Trail in 1852 through Wyoming. Her great-grandfather settled in Wyoming in 1907 as a cowhand and then raised a family of five in a tent in the Midwest oil fields, one of whom was her grandmother. And she became the first woman deputy sheriff in Natrona County. I mean, we've got good roots in the state. And so
the carpetbagger. What do the polls show?
The polls at this point, we've been focused more on images and perception and issues, and we haven't taken head to head yet, partly because it's not very useful at this stage. So I would assume at this point the incumbent's ahead. But in the 100-year history of Wyoming, we've only had one senator serve more than three terms, and that was back in the 50s. Everybody else has called it quits after three terms. Mike Enzi's had three terms. I think it's time for him to step down.